Hello everyone, this is Binisha. Welcome to Ratan IT. We are going to discuss the opacity in CSS. Okay, how I am going to this opacity values, we are going to discuss now. First of all, you need to know that what is the opacity in a browser. When you open some images, you feel like blur, it could not be focused, right? Completely you can't see that image. Some shadows also you will see opacity, that means it is transparent, that means the blur statement, and continuously it could not be completely blur. By step we can make it. So what are the properties we are going to see in CSS property? Okay, in CSS we can also make the text and images in opacity. Okay, I'm going to give, let us suppose I'm having an image. To this image, I'm giving my opacity 0.3. Why I'm going to give my opacity 0.3? Because opacity might having the range 0.0 to 1.0. This is the range of opacity. Only in between this range, we need to give the opacity here. So you can use the 0.0, 0.1, and this is the complete transparent. This is the actual image. In opacity, see, I'm having a range from 0.0, 0.1, 0.2 to 0.9 and 1.0. Right? Here my actual image starts. And coming to the 0.9, it will be slice transparent, and coming over 0.2, maximum transparent. And 0.1 almost, and completely at zero, completely transparent. According to this, we are going to use the values here. Values in 0.3. And previous, we are not using the Chrome. Nowadays, we are using the Chrome. Previous, we are going to use the internal explorer. For that time, we are going to use the opacity in alpha model. Filter alpha of 60 or 70, like that. Why this range? For alpha, it is from 0 to 100. It is from 0 to 100 range. So you can give whatever the digit or whatever the specified range from 0 to 100, you can give over there. So this will be useful in define browsers like IE, Internet Explorer, and earlier we are going to use in alpha way. Now we are not going to use in the opacity in this way. Okay, and we can also use this opacity for hover. Hover opacity 0.7 means what? That means I'm having a link. That link will be displayed fine. When I'm going to hover my mouse over here, this will be made as a blur up to 0.7. That means according to the range over here. That is the real meaning of using even hover for the opacity purpose. So opacity is a property, a CSS property. The values will be from 0.0 to 10. We are going to change the values like these, and we can also use this hover and this opacity in block and inline elements. And also for the buttons like that. Suppose if I'm going to give my image opacity 0.5, and my image will be in a box here, world map is there, world map image is there, some other like image, and I'm having the text on the map. If I'm going to opacity this image, my text is also going to be opacity. My text is also going to be very hard to read. That means my text is also became blur. When the image is going to blur, the text is also going to blur. So it became hard to read. To overcome this thing, to overcome this disadvantage, we are going to use the RGBA. What is this RGBA? In opacity, this RGBA means what? Red, green, you already know this, and B for blue, and A for alpha, okay? I'm going to use this opacity in RGBA format like this. Let us suppose I'm having IMG. Here I can use the filter RGBA of 52, 72, 64, 70. This RGBA alpha is from 0.0 to 1.0. If I am giving 0.0, it is completely transparent. If I am giving 0.5, partially transparent. If I am giving 1.0, it is not at all transparent. So in this way we are going to give the alpha. And after came the RGBA, alpha range is again from 0.0 to 1.0 only. It is not like that. Previous alpha in filter mode, it is from 0 to 100. But after RGBA came in CSS3, then the ranges came from 0.0 to 1.0. So make sure that whatever you are giving over here, in alpha, just give 0.0 to 1 as range. In between only you need to give the value. This is regarding the opacity. And for more, we are going to see in the application part. Now we are going to the another topic, that is the horizontal and vertical navigation bar. Like this, okay? This is the list. I can say all this is the list, and each and every content here is a link. Each and every content over here is a link. So I call this navigation bar as the list of links. With this navigation bar, using in CSS, I'm just making the bold HTML content into a styled HTML content. Bold HTML content into a button wise HTML styled content. Okay, how I'm going to use this? Let us suppose for navigation, I'm having HTML code with UL, an order list. Inside I'm having a list, and I'm going to close this UL, and inside this list again I'm having an anchor tag. That means every list is a link over here. So I need to use the anchor tag over here. Home. The same we need to for every list here. href is equal to have a link over here and contact, and just close the anchor tag. This is the HTML code for a navigation. So for CSS, if I want to have a horizontal navigation, so for horizontal navigation, very simple, I need to write for UL and LI. So UL and LI, this is the unorder list. First it will be displayed with a disk over here, right? So just to remove that disk, we are going to use the list style type as none. List tile type as none, and this is horizontally. List will be horizontally displayed. No, and I'm going to give my default value size margin 0 and padding 0. That means removing the default browser values. Default browser values I'm just removing over here. For horizontal navigation bar, the basic things we are going to use here. For vertical version, the small changes, the UL and LI is same equivalent over here. We are going to add is for LI and anchor tags. For horizontal, you no need a block. The horizontally the list will be displayed. Right? But coming over here in LI and A, you need to have a display block for vertical portion. And you need to specify the width. Here in CSS horizontal navigation bar, according to the browser, it will stretch completely and 100% width it will take. 100% width it will take. But coming to the vertical version, it could not take the 100%. It might take 25% or 50% width. Right? So just specify the width of 50%. Specify the width 50%. Only the vertical navigation will be like this. And we can also use more in navigation bar. The most of the things we are going to see in the application part. Now we are going to see the HTML attributes, attribute styling with it values. We already know that to the anchor tag we are giving a target with value blank. This is the attribute. Up to now we already discussed about the pseudo elements. Now we are going to discuss the attributes in styling. So using the CSS we are going to style the HTML attributes in the way like, see, first see the syntax over here. It will be applicable like selector in the square bracket will follow say attribute. Value will be option over here. If you want, you can also add the value in quotations. Okay, this is the syntax of a styling the attributes, styling the HTML attributes in CSS. Okay, now we are going to see how many ways we can style the attributes and according to that what is the real application of that. Okay, the first one is that, see, for each and everything I'm going to write the syntax over here. First is the selector. Selector follows with attribute. Okay, here anchor tag with a target. So what are the properties writing over here? Will be applicable to all the target attributes. In anchor tag. Okay. If I'm going to give the selector, I'm going to give some value here. Attribute value. That means my anchor tag target is equal to, my value is blank over here and having some properties. Means what? That means here the attribute which is there in anchor tag will also check the blank. That means the value will also check the value all target attributes but checks the value, if attribute value is blank, then only these properties will be applicable. If the target value is the blank, then only these properties will be applicable. Like that we might having several, like we can also directly have the attribute and value. Sometimes we are going to use the title attribute. Right? Here title is equal to flower. My value is flower. So means that my title name, wherever title name, at least the title name contains a flower. Then this will be belongs to, these properties will be applicable to that class. Let us suppose my title might having rose flower. Flower is there in here. So this will be applicable. Okay. And I can also write flower case. This will also be applicable over here. Let us suppose I am having a name flowers. See here flowers. This is a word. Here flowers is there? No. S is in there. But here including the yes. So this won't be applicable. Why? Because it's in a case sensitive. Flower is different. Flowers is different. So it must contain a word only, flower. Okay. That is the real meaning of this attribute. We can also have attribute or symbol and also have the value. Okay, like this means what? Let us suppose you are might having a class is equal to test. This class is equal to test will be applicable to all the attributes. It needs to be start with a test. Let us suppose text com, it containing the test and it is also starting with text. So this will be applicable over here. You might can also have test paper. This is also applicable. It does not will be like paper to test. This might not be there. Why? Because test is not the starting one. It will check the value whether it started with test or not. We can also have the another attribute with a dollar symbol will follows with value. That also class dollar is equal to test. This is for starting. This is for class starting. And dollar symbol is for ending. It will check for the ending. Okay. See, it will check like top test will be applicable. Text one. It could not be applicable. It might not be. Why? Because the test will be checked only at the end of the class name, either the attribute name, attribute value name. Okay. This is the way we are going to use all these things. We can also give the class attribute in this way, that it means, really means, we can also have the class with a multiplication symbol and need have a value that test. That means it contains, we talk about this as a starting one, we talk about this value as an ending one, Now here at least test will be contained in the attribute value name. At least it needs to be contained. Okay, we can also use some styling according to the forms. Some styling, let us suppose in form I am having an input value like this, input type is equal to text. Type is equal to text. For this type of forms, we can write the attribute, can write the input value like text. So what are the properties are there? This will check the input selector type text is there. According to this text attribute, only these properties will be applicable. You can also give your input password. Input password. If your type is the password, then only these properties will be applicable. Then only these properties will be applicable. Like that, according to the attributes, you can give several. If your input is checked attribute, you can also write for the checked. This is just to minimize the code. You can also use many selectors in this way according to the forms. According to the forms. So attribute styling we are going to do in these many different ways. We are going to see many different forms in the application part. Now straightly we are going to the another concept, that is styling the forms. Thank you for watching this video, and for more videos please subscribe to our channel Ratan IT.